today's video, I'm going to be doing this makeup look right here. It is so extra and bold eyes, bold lips, cut crease, everything that I don't do has been done in this video because I don't know, I was just feeling like I should step out of my comfort zone, do something different once in a blue moon, and this is what it looks like. I'm not the best at cut creases and doing like colorful looks. I don't think it even suits me. I think very like everyday neutral colors suit me, but either why not, like I said, jump into a different zone altogether. And makeup is fun. It's to play around with, it's to make mistakes. It's okay if you do make mistakes. All you gotta do is practice, and I wanna practice with you guys. And if I'm a little bit off here and there, it's okay. I mean, you know, I'm gonna get better at some point, but it's all about learning, practicing, watching videos every day, and making sure you get perfect at it, I guess. Close to perfect. So yeah, basically I'm gonna do this makeup look. If you want to stick around, then please do, because I create this entire eye look, full face of everything. So yeah, let's quickly jump into the video. Okay, so let's begin with moisturizer. It's super gloomy out here in Bombay and it's been raining for so many days. It's just raining non-stop, and that's why the clouds are going in and out. So the lighting might change a little bit, okay, but we're gonna move on with the tutorial because I really feel like filming today. I'm gonna use the Bobbi Brown Vitamin Face Base. This is one of my favorite moisturizers to use. It's like a face base before your makeup, and it is so good. It's slightly expensive, but it is so worth it. Like, if you're a makeup artist and if you don't know like what is the right base to put on like everyone before beginning your makeup, this is one base I highly recommend because it is so good and moisturizing on the skin. Oh my god, only if you could feel me right now. Okay, I got this Huda Beauty primer. They sent it to me in PR. This is the Complexion Perfection pre-makeup base. So I'm gonna apply that to my skin just to try it out. I didn't shake it enough, so there was liquid coming out of it. So weird. But actually, it's like this, like a cream situation. Doesn't smell like anything. It doesn't smell like anything, considering her products are fragrant. This is pretty damn good. Alright, then we move on to another primer. This is a pore filling primer. This is the Smashbox Photo Finish Primer. It's kind of blurring and really nice on the skin. Smashbox primers are great. So I usually put them around my nose area and I like press it in, just because, you know, it'll fill all the pores that we have. We have enlarged pores as we grow up. Sucks. But what are you gonna do? We have products for that that can help us with that and give you like an even base. So now I can see like it's kind of blurred and my pores are filled in, so it'll allow for a very, very smooth application of makeup. For foundation, I got this PR kit recently. This is the Bobbi Brown Skin Longwear Weightless Foundation. It is the full cover oil-free shine control. So it is sort of a matte foundation, and I'm a dry skin, but I really want to put this. I might mix it with something else if I find it too dry, but yeah, I'm gonna use this. This is in the shade Natural Tan. So I'm gonna add a little bit of the Bobbi Brown, and then I'm mixing it with the LA Girl Pro Coverage. This is the High Definition Longwear Illuminating Foundation, and I'm in the shade Nude Beige. I'm just gonna mix a little bit into that because, like I said, it's too matte for my liking. And I'm gonna take the Huda Beauty Buff and Blend brush first. I wanted to try out this brush. I have before, but not completely, so let's do that today. It's actually a pretty great brush. It's like full coverage, see? It's actually a really nice brush. Just wanted to do it on one side. Now I'm gonna take my beauty sponge because, dude, I cannot use anything else to apply my makeup for some reason. The sponge I'm using today is the La Cara sponge, and again, it's so good. It's really nice. Now that my foundation is on, we're gonna move on to concealer. I have a few concealers here that I love. Of course, the LA Girl Pro Conceal. Then I got this new Maybelline Age Rewind Concealer. It's such a great concealer. It's like an eraser, dude. It literally erases your dark circles. It's beautiful. And it's in the shade Honey. And then I have the MAC 24 Hour Studio Fix Longwear. This is the highlighting concealer. Since I use the LA Girl so much, I'm gonna try the Maybelline one. I've already tried this before and it's really great. I'm gonna use the shade Honey. Okay, so the shade Honey has a little bit of a pink undertone. Usually I would use medium, medium is actually what goes very well with me, but I just thought I'd use a darker shade to cancel out the darkness first. Like, you can see that it is so good, no jokes. This is like one of those cult concealers, you know, something that everybody has in their kit. It's like the Maybelline Fit Me Only. It is so great. So yeah, if you have like hyperpigmentation and if you have really like dark patches around your face and you don't know what to do, you really want to conceal them, try this concealer for that, and it might just do the trick. Try choosing like a one shade darker or your exact skin tone concealer to cover that pigmentation, and I think that's going to help. You'll see how it hides the pigmentation on the lid that I have. So I'm just gonna go over it with a very little amount, but it just evens out the skin tone and gives such a flawless base. A brighter concealer to just bring out the light. I know there are lights around, that's why you can't see it, but when I'm looking in the mirror, I can see some sort of darkness peeking through, and I just want to brighten the area. So don't apply like the bigger like V shape and just put so much, because you don't want so much concealer sitting underneath your eye. You want just like a little bit to help brighten your eye. I just feel like the lesser concealer you use under your eye, the less creasing you will get and less cakiness too. So just a little bit and blend it out. Okay, to set everything in place, I'm going to use my Maybelline Fit Me Loose Powder in the shade 15 Light. Very, very good powder. Highly recommend. I get a lot of girls asking me, how do I avoid creasing? How do I maintain my concealer and how does it look so flawless on you? It does crease sometimes, because as I'm growing older, I am getting like wrinkly, if you know what I mean. But the best way to do this is to take your beauty sponge and just push the concealer, okay, and look up. Okay, make sure you are pushing the concealer so it's settled in all your lines. And quickly, what you want to do is grab some powder, make sure you're still looking up, and you want to set it immediately. Okay, if you're good with just setting, set it and let it go. If you're into baking, you will do that. Just a little bit of powder. Same thing on the other eye. Don't just directly go in with powder, because now it has settled in your crease lines. Just keep pushing the product until it settles really well. Now that you see it's beautifully settled, all you want to do is take some powder and just put it on the inner corner. And now you can move. Make sure you're not putting your concealer and then just doing other things, or doing your brows and then setting it. Don't do that, big mistake. Okay, make sure you're just setting it immediately. So for the rest of my face, I'm just going to put like a light wash of powder, because I do have a matte-ish foundation on. Okay, so now that we're done setting our face a little bit, we're going to move on to our brows. Alright, so for my brows, I have two pencils right here. Both are a favorite. This is the Anastasia Beverly Hills Brow Wiz. This is in medium brown. I got this from Sephora. So if you're looking for any Anastasia product, Sephora India has it. And then the Lakme Absolute in collaboration with Kareena Kapoor Khan. This is in the shade, I think, Graphite. So these two, this is, I don't think it's available, it's discontinued, but I really needed to, I don't know, because I have it, I use it, I guess. So yeah, I'm gonna use the Anastasia Brow Wiz first. Okay, so there you have. So I filled it in a little bit and it already looks so much better than this brow, right? You can see a little gap here. So all you want to do is fill in your natural brow, and this is really great. Actually, I like the brow is. I'm going to go ahead and use the Jaclyn Hill palette. This is the Jaclyn and Morphe collaboration. I'm getting this out after so long. I forgot I even had it. What I'm going to do is use these two shadows, which is Pooter and Pukey. These two, and I'm just gonna put that on my crease. I'm gonna use the brush Pro Art AE25 for that. Again, applying it on the crease and just bringing it towards the inside. Maximum product gets applied on the outside and then pulling it towards the inside. I'm trying something new, you guys. If it doesn't work out, then it's gonna be a disaster. So I hope this works out. I really wanna expand my eyeshadow game. Now I'm gonna go ahead and use this shadow called Hunts. It's a reddish orange shadow. And I'm taking that on my PAC 116 brush. It's a sort of a dense brush. And I'm just gonna apply that in the outer corner. Pack it on, basically. Okay, I've applied this and not perfectly. I've just like carved it out. I've not blended the edges yet. Okay, because I'm gonna do a cut crease and I just want to see where this goes. I'm gonna apply a darker shadow now. Shadow now. And I'm going to take the shadow chip. Okay, which is this dark brown color here. This will help me like actually begin my tutorial now. I'm taking chip on my 008 Lakara brush. It's a tiny pencil brush and I'm just going to pack it on directly. It looks really crappy before it looks really nice. I'm hoping. Okay, I've just laid the product down. I look like I have panda eyes, I know. That's funny. Okay, I'm gonna move into Hunts, which is this red shadow right here. I'm gonna dive into this and I'm just gonna put it on top. Okay, now that I have the eyeshadow on, I'm taking a Q-tip and the Garnier Micellar water and I'm getting rid of most of the shadow that's on my lid because I want to put concealer there and do a cut crease. I'm going to try and do a cut crease. Like I said, I'm trying something new. But first, I have to get rid of some of the eyeshadow because it's just going to be a mess then. I'm taking the MAC Studio Fix Concealer in NC30. So I'm gonna put a little bit at the back of my hand so I know like I have a controlled use of the concealer. And I'm taking this Body Shop brush I've had for a while, but it's quite flat and I think I'm gonna be able to get a really good cut crease with this. I hope you guys. Whew, let's see. Okay, I took the crease a little bit higher because it's my first time and I don't know what I'm doing, but I'm trying. I'm gonna take this one here. It's called Enlight. It's this shade and it's like a very sparkly white shade and I'm gonna use that on the inner corner. Then I'm gonna take from the Huda Beauty Ruby Obsessions palette, I'm gonna take this peach color right here and I'm just gonna put that in the middle.
Okay, follow me.
And then I'm taking the Huda Beauty neon palette and I'm taking this pink color right here, which is this like Barbie pink color, and I'm just gonna put that on the outer side and I'm just gonna see what happens. Okay, I'm taking the hot pink actually. I'm taking this shade right here, which is the hot pink color. Yeah. So much better. From the neon palette, I'm gonna take this color right here, okay? This is like a really nice light pink shade. And I'm gonna go over top the earlier shade I put in the middle. And just blend the two lines out so that you don't see a difference. You see a transition basically. That's what the aim of this look is. My first time, I don't know. I'm just trying my best. Makeup is all about learning, you guys. Like honestly, I don't know what I'm doing, but I just found inspiration on Instagram. I'm gonna leave her handle down below. And just create, just have fun with makeup. I'm gonna take a gel liner. This is the Maybelline gel liner. It's one of my favorite liners to use. It lasts a really long time. So I'm gonna take this. I'm gonna create like a line here. You'll see. I'm taking that on my angle brush because I really want to create like a slant line. I'm taking the Sigma Wing Liner brush. This is the E06 brush. It's an extremely tiny brush. I'm gonna go back in and take some black eyeshadow. Okay, so I'm going to take this red shade again, Hunts, and then I'm going to follow it up with this shade right here, which is the dark shadow, and I'm just going to create a really nice transition on the lower lash line. I'm taking the PAC 102 brush and I'm just going to buff the edges. Just darkening this far out so it's more evident. Alright you guys, so this is the final eye look. It's just different combinations of colors and whatever I felt like I thought I would use. I hope it's like properly leveled. It's really difficult for me to do a cut crease because it's not my thing. I really want to dive into something different and try something new. So I'm gonna put on some lashes and then it'll probably look really nice after that. So let's put on some mascara before that. I'm gonna try wearing these Rufa Beauty lashes. I really like their lashes. This is in the shade this is in the style, I don't know, I really don't know, it's not written here, but it looks really pretty. These are the lashes. I'm picking up some black on my I222 brush and I'm gonna make it like this, a little smoky. It looks much more completed like that. Live your life. Feeling free. Just connecting this. I'm gonna take the Smashbox Always On gel liner in the shade Fishnet. It's basically a black one and I'm just gonna put that in my waterline. I'm taking the shade Hunts once again, like the red shade, and I'm just gonna go over underneath. Complex makeup look. I'm just doing whatever actually I feel will look good. There's no particular rule over here. I'm just winging it as I go to see where to add the color next, where I think it'll look good. That is the complete look. Oh my god, I can't believe I finished this look. I thought I'm gonna sit here all day. I'm gonna use the Hoola bronzer to contour and bronze my face. Taking that on my Nameless MAC brush and I look so washed out, so I'm gonna add some color back into my face. New blush, My Glam Pose HD blush. This is the new one they sent me. This is the packaging of it, really pretty. It's called Coral Punch. There are two blushes. I'm sort of like mixing both of them. One is mauvey, one is coral, so I don't know, mixing both of them for the best effect. Highlighter, we have the My Glam Pose Highlighter Duo. This is in Champagne and Rose Gold. I think I'm gonna take this color, Champagne. I think that's the one that'll suit me the most. Ooh, not bad at all. So nice. For lipstick, I'm taking this pink color since I have a little bit of pink going on in the eye. This is called Bachelorette. And I'm just gonna line my lips with the My Glam lip pencil. This is in the shade Sass. That's all I have for you. This is the final result. It's very unlike me. I thought I'd do something different instead of the usual. This is so not me, and it does not suit my face, but I thought I would do something creative. So I don't know, it's like a break in the monotony, I guess. I will be back to my regular videos very soon. Thank you so much for watching, and please subscribe before you leave, and I will see you in my next one. Bye you guys. Mwah.